Obeying the Gospel, October 4th, the washing of water with the Word, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the Word, Ephesians 5:26. To accomplish the purposes of Christ, the church must be sanctified. This word sounds like nothing more than religious lingo to some, but its concept is important and not hard to understand. To be sanctified is to be set apart for special use. To use a humorous example, I have an iron skillet in which I've never made anything but cornbread. When I bought it long ago, I set it apart for that purpose, and it has had to be content to be different from my other skillets. To maintain the magnificence of the cornbread that's cooked in it, it simply cannot come into contact with certain other things. And knowing skillet nature as I do, I'm sure my other skillets accused the cornbread skillet of being self-righteous. Now, on a much more serious note, Christ gave himself up for the church in order that he might sanctify her. The whole plan by which Christ was able to have a set-apart people depended on his dying for those people. Not in 50 lifetimes could any of us have kept enough mitzvot, or commandments, for even one of our sins to be forgiven. The Messiah had to die for our atonement, as was prophesied in Isaiah 53:4-6. Also, back in Ephesians 5:26, we see that Christ cleansed her by the washing of water with the Word. This is a reference to the baptism, or immersion in water, in which all who are now in Christ came to be so, Romans 6:3, Galatians 3:27, as a result of hearing the Word of the Lord concerning the forgiveness of their sins. Paul makes the point in triplicate in 1 Corinthians 6:11, where, after referring to those whose lives were given to sin, he said, "And such were some of you, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God." How then does Christ sanctify the church? He does it individually. One day the process will be finished, but only for those who have entered that process individually in the here and now. Listen to this remark by Robert F. Turner. "We note that some seem to think there is a future time when, by some process undefined, Christ will cleanse the present filthy and sinful church. Current imperfections are thus excused. We beg to differ with this traditional interpretation. We do not question the future reception of the church as the bride of Christ, 2 Corinthians 11:2-3, Revelation 21:2. But we believe the setting apart and cleansing is now taking place and has been in process ever since the gospel of Christ was first preached."